really there are four levels of ways stress can affect your digestive tract or your gut. And the first one is your nervous stomach. So those are the butterflies, the kind of pit in your stomach when you're anxious about that presentation or something. That's level one. Then you move on to level two, which is more of an upset stomach, that urgent, I got to get to the bathroom ASAP kind of feeling. You're going to have some loose stool or diarrhea. Number three is gas and bloating, that very uncomfortable distension where you just can't button up your pants and you feel lousy. And then level four, DEFCON 4, is stomach pain. So actual pain or real discomfort where you really don't feel like you can even sit still. You're really uncomfortable. So those are the four levels, and I'm going to go through them one by one. Level one, like I said, the nervous stomach, the butterflies in your stomach. What's happening here? So when your brain gets stimulated by anxiety or nerves, it sends signals down to your gut through what's called the vagus nerve. This is one of the largest, most important nerves in your body. And the vagus nerve then stimulates your gut to move, to contract. And that's what gives you that sort of somersault-like feeling. So level two is that urgent, upset stomach, gotta run to the bathroom feeling. And what's happening here is some of the same neurotransmitters, things like serotonin that are released in your brain, are also released by the lining of your gut. And sometimes if those go haywire, it can cause an overactive, overspeedy digestion. Now, another setup for that is an imbalance of good and bad bacteria in your gut. So one thing to make you more resilient to stress on your gut is to make sure your microbiome, that healthy community of bacteria, is totally balanced. So I have a bunch of foods here that are going to help you do that. They have probiotics. Those are healthy, good for you bacteria, but also prebiotics. And those are the foods that fuel the good bacteria that's already in your gut. So we all know about yogurt, right? Yogurt with live and active culture is great for the probiotics. But if you're not a big yogurt fan, kefir is a fermented drink. That's something to try. It has kind of like a yogurt flavor, but it's very unique. And then another great source of probiotics, kimchi. We know our Korean friends make this fermented cabbage, which is delicious. And then finally, sauerkraut, another great source of a rich variety of different strains of probiotics. Prebiotic foods, we have asparagus, we have leeks here. Again, two good sources of prebiotics. They're going to help your good bacteria that's already in your gut flourish and grow. And then we move on to number three. So three is gas and bloating. And we've all, you know, overindulged and felt that a little bit, but sometimes stress can make that a major issue. What's happening there is the stress is affecting how you digest your food, and then your food is producing more gas, more air in the system, which leads to that real distended feeling, very uncomfortable. So what can we do when we have that overbloated feeling? Well, we all know exercise is great for our body, but a lot of people don't realize exercise actually helps your colon start moving. And it moves that gas along so that it's not going to stay in your system. The other thing to do if you're having too much gas and bloating, avoid chewing gum, using straws, or drinking a lot of carbonated beverages.
Carbonated beverages I get, but I never thought about chewing gum.
Yeah, you know what? When you chew gum, you're actually swallowing air during that act of chewing. If you think about it, you know, your mouth is open. And with straws as well, you end up getting a lot of air in your system. So just doing some few tips like that can help you really calm down the gas and the bloating. And then the last level we talked about, level four, that really bad abdominal pain or abdominal discomfort. This is usually due to a spasming of your intestines. So really, you know, that kind of wrenching pain that you might get because of stress. And sometimes it can happen immediately after a very stressful situation. So here again, the hormones and the chemicals are affecting your gut. And we know that deep breathing can break this cycle, meditation, acupuncture. But if you want something quick that you can just do at home, acupressure is another thing to try. And I'm going to show you two spots on your abdomen that can really help release that tension. So if you can see here, you find your belly button and then you go 2 inches above. And I'm just using two fingers. You can use two or three fingers and slowly in a circular motion, massage for about 2 or 3 minutes. This is going to help release the spasming of the upper abdomen area. If you're feeling more tension in the lower abdomen, you find a belly button again and go 4 inches below. And again, 2 to 3 fingers, massaging gently. And that can really help release the spasming and help release the pain. Any of these things are very severe or happening frequently, please talk to your doctor. This is not a time to sit home and wait.